Hello everyone, welcome back to another session in Dentistry and More. Topic for today is resin bonded FPD. So fixed partial denture, we commonly follow a peculiar scenario, that is if you are replacing the 3-6. So we just cannot put 3-6 here. Sometimes we can put it like that, but it need to be an implant. But we are talking about fixed partial denture, not an implant. So in that case, we need to take support from 3-5 and 3-7. Okay, so what we do is we plan a 3-unit crown. So we plan a 3-unit crown. So we will make a 3-unit crown. So in order to get the support for 3-6, 3-5 and 3-7 are sacrificed, because it was natural tooth, it had no problem, it was caries free, it was sound. Still we sacrificed 3-5 and 3-7 just to get the support for 3-6. So that is a common scenario of fixed partial denture. But the resin bonded FPD is having an innovative idea, that is we are not going to sacrifice 3-5 and 3-7. What we are doing is we are keeping an additional attachment from the 3-6, that is the bone tick. The attachment will be towards 3-5 and 3-7. There will not be much destruction of 3-5 and 3-7. The tooth structure will be maintained. The tooth structure will not be destroyed much. A little bit of enamel will be etched or other procedure, but it is very much differs from the conventional FPDs. So it is nothing but the resin bonded FPDs. We use resins to bond to the abutment teeth in order to get the support for the tooth. That is the concept of resin bonded FPD. So resin bonded FPD is a process that requires minimal removal of tooth structure, particularly for the abutment teeth that are intact and caries free. So the primary goal of the resin bonded FPD is a replacement of missing teeth and maximum conservation of tooth structure. So as per definition, it is a process that is luted to tooth structure, primarily enamel, which has been etched to provide mechanical retention for the composite resin. So we use resin for the mechanical locking, and also enamel etching will be there. So we use wings like appliance or apparatus which will be attached to the abutment tooth using a mechanical lockage instead of destruction or preparation of tooth. So there will be very minimal preparation of the abutment tooth, but we will get the enough support. So once the acid etching technique has been popular, the resin bonded FPDs are introduced to the market because it involves acid etching. So in these FPDs, like I told, there will be metal framework which is like wings attached to the abutment tooth. So what exactly is the difference between conventional FPDs and resin bonded FPDs? So in conventional FPDs, the greater amount of tooth structure destruction will be there, but in resin bonded FPD there will be very minimal tooth preparation requires, and the conventional FPDs aesthetically may not be very pleasing, but in resin bonded it can be given in both anterior and posterior region because of its pleasing aesthetics. And missing tooth as well as the abutment teeth has to be replaced in case of conventional FPDs, but in resin bonded FPDs only the missing tooth is replaced, the abutment teeth is not affected. So what are the types of resin bonded FPDs? It's a very commonly asked question. The first one is crochet bridge, the second one is Maryland bridge, the third one is cast mesh FPD, cast mesh fixed partial denture, and the fourth one is Virginia bridge. It differs from the mechanism of bonding. So first one is Rochet bridge. So as you see the picture here, it have funnel shaped perforations in the wings. So I told you there will be wings which is starting from the pontic towards the abutment. Okay, so this wings having perforations to enhance the retention, you can see it here. So there will be combined silane coupling agent to produce adhesion to the metal. So there will be a coupling agent which will produce the adhesion. So the second one is Maryland Bridge. In Maryland Bridge, adapted electrochemical pit corroding technique. Electrochemical pit corroding technique, that is 3.5% of nitric acid is used for 5 minutes with current of 250 milliampere, followed by immersion of 18% hydrochloric acid in an ultrasonic cleaner for 10 minutes. So this is how it create porosities for the adhesion, that is the electrochemical pit corrosion. 3.5% nitric acid for 5 minutes, then 250 milliampere current with 18% of hydrochloric acid for 10 minutes. So the resin alloy bond will be having a strength of 27.3 megapascal. So this specific to non-beryllium nickel chromium alloy. Non-beryllium nickel chromium alloy, which is 2.9 times, almost 3 times more retentive than the perforated type. 3 times more retention. So, but this is a technique sensitive one. Overetching produces electro polished surface. The next one is cast mesh fixed partial denture. So it is non-etching method. Okay, non-etching method, unlike the other two, where a net-like nylon mesh is placed over the lingual surfaces of abutment teeth. You can see here in the cast, the mesh is incorporated in the retainer wax pattern. So if the mesh blocked out by the wax, when investing, retention will be compromised. So it should not be blocked out. So it is a non-etching type, where a net-like nylon mesh is placed over the lingual surface of the abutment teeth in the cast. So the mesh is incorporated in the retainer wax pattern. That is the concept of cast mesh FPD, which is a non-etching type. Whereas the Virginia Bridge, it is by the incorporation of salt crystals. Into the retainers to produce roughness in inner surface. That is why it is known as lost salt technique. Lost salt technique. So retainer pattern fabricated with resin with 1 mm wide crystal free zone around the outline. The salt is dissolved in water after the resin polymerizes. Cubic voids act as a retentive component. So aluminium oxide used as a surface treatment, that is air abrasion, to improve bonding with resin. So that is a Virginia Bridge, which is also known as lost salt technique. So what are the advantages of this resin bonded FPDs? The main advantage is there is no LA, that is local anesthesia, because most of the tooth preparation involves just enamel, then it is mostly involving just supra gingival margin. There is no subgingival involvement, and it is having very minimal tooth preparation, so it is very conservative, minimal tooth lost. Then it can be rebounded if the axial adhesion get loose. Can be rebounded. So these are various advantages of resin bonded, but the disadvantages are the some amount of some sound tooth structure has to be lost. There will be enamel loss that is invariably associated with the bonding process. Then the longevity, that is a bigger problem. compared to the conventional FPDs, and the alignment correction is not possible. Alignment correction is not possible with this, because sometimes the tooth will be in a buccal position or lingual position or mesial or distal. We just cannot tilt the alignment. If it is in a conventional FPD, we can just alter the preparation and make the alignment in a parallel way, but this is not possible because we are just attaching some wings like apparatus on the abutment tooth. There is no change in the gross structure of the abutment tooth, so alignment is not possible to be corrected. So next is temporization is not possible, that is a provisional prosthesis cannot be fabricated. Provisional restoration is not possible. Not possible. That is, temporization is not possible. So we are directly attaching it to the tooth. So we were talking about the advantages and disadvantages. Now let's see what are the indications. It is indicated when caries-free abutment teeth are present. Caries-free abutment teeth, and mostly on the mandibular incisor replacement or maxillary incisor replacement, or periodontally compromised abutment with reinforcement of resistance feature while preparing the tooth. Periodontally compromised tooth or single posterior tooth replacement. So these are indications, but it is contraindicated when there is excessive caries, nickel sensitivity, and deep overbite. When overbite is more, you just cannot perform this one. So what are the things we should think about while doing tooth preparation? That is axial reduction and guide plane on proximal surface with slight extension onto the facial surface, which can provide a facio-lingual lock. Okay, so facio-lingual lock. Facio-lingual lock. It is mainly based on the mechanical bonding. So axial reduction and guide plane on proximal surface with slight extension onto the facial surface, so it will create a facio-lingual lock. And we should give a light chamfer finish line, light chamfer finish line with 1 mm supragingivally to enhance resistance. 180 degree tooth preparation is to be done. 180 degree tooth preparation to enhance the retention. So the large surface area is involved to improve bonding because it is mainly based on the mechanical bonding, and occlusal clearance sometimes can be employed. Vertical stops are placed like flat counter sinks on lingual surface of incisors, cinculum rest on canine, occlusal rest seat on premolars and molars. So grooves are used near the fascio proximal line ankle, then an opposite side of cingulum or lingual cusp, creating a wraparound effect. For mandibular premolars, full coverage of lingual cusp is done. So molars also have lingual cusp coverage preparation. Inlays can be attached to anatomical grooves on distolingual surface. Axial coverage extending through proximal contact to connect with occlusal rest. So we need a high speed handpiece, articulating ribbon, small wheel and short needle diamond burr. So all these things we need. So that was all about our topic, resin bonded FPD. So it was a newer technique after the acid etching technique was introduced, because the conventional FPDs are having the main disadvantage of tooth restriction. The abutment tooth are sacrificed for the retention of the pontic or the tooth to be replaced. So if we have an option where it is indicated when the abutment is caries free and all other indications are fine. So we can go for a resin bonded FPD where wings like attachment from the pontic towards abutment will give proper retention. So it has many advantages, such as very minimal destruction because it is just attaching on enamel, and at the same time there is some problem too because it just cannot tilt the angulation of the abutment because there is no gross change of the shape or alignment of the tooth. So hope you understood this concept of resin bonded over the conventional FPD, and these four are the various types, that is Rochet, Maryland, Cast Mesh and Virginia. This will be asked separately as a short note, and this resin bonded as a short essay. So you can write about its indication, contraindication, advantage, disadvantage and these types with pictures. So I'll come up with a new topic in dentistry and more. Thank you.